Continue pa rin natin yung problem dito. So ngayon, proceed tayo sa roof truss analysis due to wind loads. So na-derive na natin yung mga nodal loads due to wind loads. So you can check out our previous discussion with regard dito. So punta lang kayo sa playlist, doon yung sa wind engineering. Okay. So i-solve natin to, or mag-perform tayo dito ng roof truss analysis considering itong mga nodal loads due to wind load. So sa previous discussion, na compute na natin yung mga support reactions dito sa roof truss natin, ha. So na compute na natin to last time. So pass forward ko na lang doon. So ito yung mga nodal loads natin, and then ito yung na-compute natin ng mga support reactions. So pa-check na lang sa previous discussion natin for this one, for the calculation of support reactions. So we have GY, which is 30.35 kilonewton downward, and then we have also EX, which is 10.12 kilonewton to the negative X direction, and we have summation of forces vertical, and then we have calculated the value of AY, which is 23.775 kilonewton downward. So na-compute na natin to last time. Ngayon, kukunin na natin yung mga member forces dito sa truss natin. Okay, so ito na yun. So let's isolate itong joint A dito. So bali ito yung joint A natin. So ito yung mga connected members na meron tayo. So we have this angle 30 degrees. And then we have the support reaction AY, which is 23.775 kilonewton, and also 10.12 kilonewton. And then we have also this external load due to wind load, which is 6.273 kilonewton, which is at 90 degrees with respect to the rafter. And then that is inclined at 60 degrees. So ngayon, assume muna natin na yung force dito sa AB is in tension, meaning pinupull out niya yung pin. Anyway, this is just an assumption. And then dito naman, let's assume this one is in compression, yung member ED. Anyway, itong dalawa is just an assumption. So mabiberify natin ngayon yan kung tama yung assumption natin once we do the calculation. So by summation of forces along Y equal to 0, so let's assume lahat ng forces going up is taken as positive. So therefore, meron tayo dito ng going down, which is negative 23.775. No? It is taken as negative kasi baliktad siya sa assumption natin. And then dito sa 6.273, so yung vertical component nito is andito, so going up. So that is positive, no? So positive 6.273 sine 60. And also itong AB, which is going up pa rin, so positive. So considering yung force na to, so yung forces going up niya is FEB sine 30. So wala na tayong ibang force along Y kasi yung 10.12 tsaka AD is along X. So pwede na tayong mag-equal to 0. Thus, we have force EB, which is 36.685 kilonewton. So, positive yung nakuha natin na result. Therefore, yung assumption natin is tama, which is in tension. So, tama yung assumption natin na tension siya. And then, by summation of forces along X equal to 0. So, let's assume na going to positive X direction is taken as positive. So, lahat ng forces na ganito yung direction, taken as positive. So, therefore, ito is going to the negative X direction, so 10.12, so it should be taken as negative. And then, ito din, no, yung component niya is also going to the left. No? So, that's why we should take it as negative also. No? So, we have yung X component na to. So, we have 6.273 cosine 60. And it should be negative kasi baliktad siya sa assumption natin. And then, itong force AB going to positive x direction. So, same siya sa assumption natin. So, it should be taken as positive FAB cosine. It should be 30 degrees. Okay. So, okay, ito na. So, FAB cosine 30. Yun dito. And then, meron tayong negative FAD. No? Kasi baliktad siya sa assumption pa rin natin. So, wala tayong ibang force going along x. So, kasi yung AY is along y. So, pwede na tayong mag-equal to 0. And then, we have this linear equation in terms of EB. I mean, ED. Kasi yung EB natin dito is given. Ay, di siya given. Nasold na natin. So, parang meron na tayong value nito. So, ito na. So, meron na tayo dito. So, yung assumption natin dito, this one is intention. Ito is naka-tension to. Eh. So, ibig sabihin, yung ilalagay natin dito is itong value na to. No? Yung positive 36.685 kilonewton. So, ngayon, meron na tayong ED. Okay? So, we have negative 10.12 minus 6.273 cosine 60 plus 36.685 cosine 60 plus 36.685 cosine 30 minus FED. Therefore, we have FED which is 18.51 kilonewton. So, positive yung nakuha nating result. So, therefore, itama yung assumption natin na this one is indeed in compression. Okay? So, meaning, itong ED is in compression. So, meaning, kung ito yung pin, pushing siya dyan, pushing. So, ganun din dito, no? Pinupush niya. Itong ED naman is in tension. So, bali, hilain niya ito. So, hila siya dito. Kung ito yung piniconsider natin, hilain niya yan. Na? Hila siya dyan by a magnitude of 36.685 kilonewton. Next, isolate joint B. Okay, so yung joint B naman yung i-consider natin. So for joint B, so ito yung mga connected members natin. Yan. So this one is 90 degrees. So kung 30 degrees to, ito siya. So bali dito is also 30 degrees. And by vertical angle theorem, this one is also 30 degrees. And then ito yung external load applied natin which is 9.904 kilonewton. And then meron na tayong nakuha dito ng magnitude na. Like actual na member force dito, including yung actual sign niya. So, meaning this one is in tension. So, hilain niya. 36.685. Then dito, di natin alam. So, we just assume it as tension. FBC and also this one, FBD. Anyway, this is just an assumption. Again, when we do our calculation, verify natin yan kung tama yung assumption natin. So, assume na lang natin, this one is our x-axis, this one is our y-axis. So, by summation of forces vertical. So, therefore, we have 9.904 and then it is going down. So, minus FBD. Therefore, FBD is 9.904 kilonewton. So, yung nakuha nating result dito is positive. Therefore, tama yung assumption natin na indeed, no? Yung member BD is in tension. And then, by summation of forces along x equal to 0. So, assuming natin na yung direction dito, going to this direction is positive. So, therefore, this one is taken as negative. Negative 36.685 plus itong force dito. So, it should be taken as positive kasi same siya sa assumption natin. Equal to 0, therefore, we have FBC which is 36.685 kilonewton. So, since yung nakuha natin is positive, therefore, tama yung assumption natin. Indeed, no? Yung member BC is in tension. So, kung tension to, so, which means na ito siya ay sinihila niya, na? Kung ito yung P natin, hilain niya yan. The magnitude of 36.685. So, dito naman, meron tayong hila pa rin, na? Kasi tension. So, kung ito yung P naman natin, so, hilain niya yan. Okay, considering this member PD. At the magnitude of 9.90. Okay na tayo dyan, ha? Next is, we isolate itong joint D. Okay, ito naman. So, ito yung joint D natin. So, ito yung mga connected members dyan sa joint D. So, ito may mga forces na tayo dito na yung wala lang tayo sa dito. So, ito naka 60 degrees yan. Ito din naka 60 degrees. So, meron tayo dito yung actual forces na 18.51. And then, we have this intention na 9.904. This one is intention. This one is in compression. So ito, di natin alam, so but we can do our assumption for this one. So let's assume na yung member DC is intention and also itong member DE is intention. So by summation of forces along y equal to 0, so let's assume na lahat ng forces going up is taken as positive. Therefore, we have 9.904 sine 60 plus, kasi itong FDC is again going up. So FDC sine 60. So, wala tayong ibang force along y. So, pwede natin mag-equal to 0. Thus, FDC is, yung nakuha nating result dito is negative. No? So, negative 9.904 kilonewton. So, since negative yung sign na nakuha natin, so meaning mali yung assumption na ginawa natin. No? Mali yung assumption natin dito na yung DC is intention. So, yung tamang direction should be in compression. So, sabihin na lang natin, this is or positive 9.904 kilonewton, but in compression siya, hindi in tension. Okay? And then, by summation of forces along x equal to 0, so therefore, we have this one going to positive x direction. Same siya sa assumption natin, so it should be taken as positive. So, we have 18.51 plus itong FDE, and then meron tayong minus nung x component nito, which is 9.904 cosine 60. And then ito naman yung x component nito is plus FDC cosine 60. Take note yung ginawa ang yung direction nito is intention na. So meaning kung ano yung unit kung ano yung value nito, numeric value niya na yung intention pa siya, yun yung gagamitin natin dito. So yung intention pa siya is ito yan, no. Okay? Yung may negative. So dapat yung ilagay natin dito is naka-negative, hindi positive. Okay? Kasi yung FDC is naka-base dito sa yung in-assume natin na intention. Okay? So, I hope klaro yun. So, yun yung gamitin natin, hindi yung positive. Kasi ito is in compression. Eh, no? Okay, so ngayon, we have now 18.51 plus FDE minus 9.904 cosine 60 plus, ngayon, ilagay natin yung negative. Negative 9.904 cosine 60, therefore we have FDE. So yung nakuha nating value dito is, again, negative. So, negative 8.606 kilonewton. So meaning, mali yung assumption natin dito, no? Na yung D is intention. So mali yan, ha? So yung tamang direction niya is in compression. Or, sabihin na lang natin, or this is positive 8.606 kilonewton, pero naka-in compression siya. Okay? So ngayon, alam na natin na itong dalawa to is in compression. So, meaning this one is pushing the pin kung itong member DE. So, ito yung pin naman, ipupush niya yan. No? Ganun din dito, no? This is pushing the pin and then dito is pushing the pin. So, at a magnitude of 9.904 kilonewton. So, okay na tayo halfway nung thrust natin. So, dito naman tayo sa kabilang side. So, let's isolate itong joint G dito. So, ito yung joint G natin. Then, meron tayong mga connected members dito. So, incline at 30 degrees. Then, meron tayo ditong support reaction at 30.35 and also an external load of 12.282 kilonewton at an angle of 60 degrees. So, ngayon, di natin alam kung yung direction dito. So, we can, again, make an assumption. So, let's assume na this one is in tension while this one is in compression. So, by summation of forces vertical equal to 0, so lahat ng forces going up is taken as positive. So, therefore, we have, ito na, this is going down, negative 30.35 kasi going down. And then, meron tayo ditong y component nitong 12.282, no? Going up siya, so it should be taken as positive. Positive 12.282 sine 60. And also, ganun din yung sa GF. So, we have FGF sine 30. Equal to 0. So, meron tayong linear equation in terms of GF. Therefore, yung force dito sa member GF is 39.43 kilonewton. So, since positive yung nakuha natin na results, so, meaning, tama yung assumption natin na yung member GF is indeed in tension. And then, by summation of forces along x equal to 0, so, assuming na lang natin na lahat ng forces going to positive x direction is taken as positive. So, therefore, meron tayo ditong positive FGE plus yung x component nito, which is positive 12.282 cosine 60. Okay? So, positive siya kasi positive Going siya sa positive x direction. Same siya sa assumption. Pero ito is baliktad siya sa assumption. So it should be taken as negative. Negative yung component x nito. So FGF cosine 30. So wala tayong ibang force along x. So pwede natin mag-equal to 0. So yung GF natin, take note dito. Yung GF natin dito is intention. No? Yung nakuha natin na result dyan, intention is ito. So ito yung ilagay natin for GF. So bali, ito na lang yung masolve natin. Okay, so therefore we have FGA, which is, okay, so ito pala. So we have FGA plus 12.282 cosine 60 minus 39.43 cosine 30 equal to 0. Thus, yung FGF is 28.006 kilonewton. So since positive yung nakuha natin na result, so meaning tama yung assumption natin na indeed na yung GE is in compression. So ito na yung sagot. So thus, considering itong P na to, okay, yung F or itong GF, this one is intention. So meaning hilain niya yan. Kung ito yung pin, hilain niya yan. At a magnitude of 39.43. Dito din, since this one, yung GE is in compression. So meaning kung ito yung pin, push niya yan. No? Yan dito. Tsaka yung dito, push niya yan. Okay. So push, push. At a magnitude of 28.006. So tatlo na lang. No? Tatlo na lang yung tap. So let's isolate itong joint F. So isolating joint F, ito yung makukuha nating result, no? So meron tayo ditong pin F. So ito, may nakuha na tayo dito, di ba, na intention, 39.43. Then meron tayo ditong external load na 19.391, which is at 60 degrees or 30 degrees mag-base tayo sa vertical. So meaning, itong FC, tsaka itong FE, no? So by summation of forces, vertical equal to 0. So makikita natin dito na yung FE, very obvious, no? Kasi inline lang to, tsaka inline lang to. So yung F, yung FE, tsaka ito inline, no? Yung FE is equivalent lang nitong 19.391. So kung ito siya is hila, so ganoon din dito hila. So we have 19.391 kilonewton tension, and then by summation of forces along X, very obvious na yung FC is also 39.43 kilonewton. Or using this equilibrium equation, so we have negative 39.43 kasi ito yung x-axis natin na going positive. Okay, so going to positive x direction should be taken as positive. So bali dito, going siya dito. Okay, so ito yung positive, ito yung negative. Or very obvious, no? So bali dito is intention tong dalawa. So meaning, kung ito yung pin, hilain niya. Kung ito yung pin, hilain niya. So dito din, at a magnitude of 39.43 yung FC. Ito din, silain niya, tsaka ito hilain niya. At a magnitude of 19.39. So, isin na lang yung natira. So, now, we can now isolate joint E. So, kung ito yung joint E, ito yung mga connected members natin. So, ito yung mga inclination nila at 60 degrees. So, dito, may nakuha na tayo na 8.606. And then, dito, meron na tayong, anong pa pala ito, na? So, this will be EC, na? So, ano niyan? So, this is just an assumption. So, in-assume natin na this one is in tension. And then, may nakuha na tayo ditong result, no? Which is 19.391 and also dito, which is in compression na 28.006. So, to solve for EC, so we just take summation of forces Y equal to 0. So, lahat ng forces going up is taken as positive. I think enough na to, no? Pero pwede rin summation of forces X, no? It's up to you. Pero yung forces along Y is okay na. Kasi isa lang yung unknown eh. Kasi isang equation lang yung kailangan. So, yung FEC, vertical component nito is we have EC sine 60. So, positive kasi going up man to. And also itong 19.391, no? Sine 60 going up pa rin sa positive equal to 0. So, thus, okay, so sorry for that. It should be EC. So thus, yung FEC natin is equivalent to, this one is being transposed, no? So magiging negative yan, cancel out yung sin 60. So we have negative 19.391 kilonewton. So since negative yung result, so meaning mali yung assumption natin. Huh? So hindi siya in tension. It should be in compression. So sabihin na natin, or this is positive 19.391 kilonewton compression. Okay, so ayok, klaro yun dito. So therefore, dito sa member na to, lahat yan pushing, no? So push, push. at a magnitude of 19.391 kilonewton. So ito na, no? So ito na yung roof truss analysis natin due to wind loads. Okay? So if you like this video, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, and you can also get notified na dun sa Facebook page namin. So the link is in the description below. So again, continue pa rin natin yung problem na to. So next nito is we need to calculate for the design force na gagamitin natin for the design. Okay? So doon na papasok si load combination. So since nakuha na natin lahat ng mga service loads. Okay, so see you in the next video. Thank you.